Welcome, welcome. Breaking news here. This video is about the new VRoid Studio beta to stable, and it's going to teach you how to import your old hair presets and to update your old model so that you have a seamless transition into the new stable version of VRoid. Step by step for you to keep your existing models and hair presets that you may have made or downloaded, while still having the benefit of dabbling in the new VRoid Studio Stable version as a separate program. This video is not going to be on the new features, but more so for the underdogs who have not yet seen the new VRoid Studio or are feeling cautious about their old models. Of course, I wanted to share this info with you to help you all as soon as I learned about it. I was cautious about just blindly updating, and I didn't want to lose my hard work. And I know that you didn't want to either, and I don't want that for you. So first, what you'll do is download and install the beta version 0.14 separately. If you have VRoid connected to a Steam account like I did, this is the way to go. The link is in the description down below. For using avatar models you created from old VRoid beta, you have to convert them. But where do you put them? And where are they located? What is changed is the new file saves when you start up the stable version. Second, before doing any opening of the stable version, we will go to the old beta VRoid Studio you just downloaded and open your old model files to save your hair presets one by one as models on their own, as you can see me do here. I have one of my models. This is one of my 3D models, but as you can see here, I saved this hair on this model as hair model underscore M straight with waves. I'm going to show you how you can do this for each one of your hair presets. So here I will go to another hair preset called M Basic Long, import from preset. And then I'm just going to save as hair model and change the name to M Basic Long so that in the future I'll know which hair I'm looking at. And I save it. Old VRoid will go into not responding, which hopefully is fixed with the new stable version. And then after it goes into not responding, I will quit VRoid to open it again to do a different preset. Presets saved as models will enable you to not only update your model into the new VRoid stable version, but also will help you to keep a count of and save all of your hair presets. I had 42. I don't know how many you guys have, but you could just save certain favorites or however you would like to do it. So I will reopen it again and show you how it is done. So here's my little crack at my 2D model, which you may or may not have seen in my other video on how to make your model look like a 2D model or anime drawn character. So we're gonna test it on her as well and save her with a new hair preset. So we're just gonna go to hair editor, and here we're gonna go to preset 17. So we can save that. Looking very edgy, we're gonna save as hair model. This is just my naming convention, but you guys can use whatever you want. This is so that I do not lose any of my presets while I'm waiting for them to update or come up with some faster way for us to be able to import our old presets. So here I'm gonna save. And you will repeat this process for as many hair presets as you have. Hopefully you guys are not going to be inundated with hair presets and that it will be fairly easy for you. Okay, this is a little bit of information on the location, file extension names changed here. As you can see here, your old beta files will still be located in the same folder where they originally were. C, users, whatever your computer name is, app data, local low, pixiv, and VRoid Studio. No space. But the new files will be located, once you do save them, the new files will be located in C, users, whatever your computer name is, AppData, Localo, Pixiv, VRoid, Space, Studio. Note the space and the difference in your file folder names here. There is a space between VRoid Studio, for the new version, and there is no space for the old version of VRoid Studio. The file extension changes. All the new VRoid Studio stable save items have new file extension names now. The converted hair can be found at C, users, your computer name, AppData, Localo, Pixiv, VRoid Studio, custom items, which is the new folder name, and then the name of your preset, .VRoid custom item. This is a key change for you to be able to recognize what you're working with. The old preset folders will simply say hair presets. In theory then, I believe this could mean that in the future with items on booth and such, you should just be able to convert the hair as you did previously did and save, share the .VRoid custom item file instead of the name preset or sharing a preset folder, etc. Well, that's it so far. I will keep you updated on any new changes or areas that I find would be helpful to you. I hope this video sheds a little light on the what, where's, and why's of the situation with old beta version and how to safely update to the new stable version of VRoid Studio. I strive to deliver value content to you on VTubing, relationship dynamics, and advice, as well as a variety of content. So, if you liked this video or are interested in seeing more content like this, hit that subscribe button and notification. And best of all, share this video with anyone who may still be confused or cautious about updating and the new versus the old VRoid Studio. So thank you for watching, and please, if you have any questions, leave them down below. I'll be happy to answer them, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Social revolution. Rackets, it's a chains, emotion, evolution, whip your energy brain. Waiting for a savior to save us, time to arrive. I strive to deliver value content to you on VTubing, relationship dynamic advice. Blah. Start that again. I will keep you updated on any new changes or areas that I find might be helpful to you. And here I have. What the fuck is it not showing? I do need the stream deck, and I'll see you in the next one. Fuck.